Aaliyah artistry. Voice and style. Aaliyah had the vocal range of a soprano. With the release of her debut album Age Ain't Nothing But a Number, writer Dimitri Ehrlich of Entertainment Weekly compared her style and sound to R&B group En Vogue. Ehrlich also expressed that Aaliyah's silky vocals are more agile than those of self-proclaimed queen of hip-hop soul Mary J. Blige. In her review for Aaliyah's second studio album One in a Million Vibe magazine, music critic Dream Hampton said that Aaliyah's deliciously feline voice has the same pop appeal as Janet Jackson's. Aaliyah described her sound as street but sweet, which featured her gentle vocals over a hard beat. Though Aaliyah did not write any of her own material, her lyrics were described as in-depth. She incorporated R&B, pop and hip-hop into her music. Her songs were often up-tempo and at the same time often dark, revolving around matters of the heart. After her R. Kelly-produced debut album, Aaliyah worked with Timbaland and Missy Elliott, whose productions were more electronic. Sasha Freer-Jones of The Wire finds Aaliyah's Are You That Somebody? To be Timbaland's masterpiece and exemplary of his production's start-stop rhythms, with big half-second pauses between beats and voices. Keith Harris of Rolling Stone cites Are You That Somebody? As one of 90s R&B's most astounding moments. Aaliyah's songs have been said to have crisp production and staccato arrangements that extend genre boundaries while containing old-school soul music. Kalafasane of the New York Times called Aaliyah a digital diva who wove a spell with ones and zeros, and writes that her songs comprise simple vocal riffs, repeated and refracted to echo the manipulated loops that create digital rhythm, as Timbaland's computer program beats fitted perfectly with her cool, breathy voice to create a new kind of electronic music. When she experimented with other genres on Aaliyah, such as Latin pop and heavy metal, Entertainment Weekly's Craig Seymour panned the attempt. While analyzing her eponymous album, British publication NME, New Musical Express felt that Aaliyah's radical third album was intended to consolidate her position as U.S.R.&B's most experimental artist. As her albums progressed, writers felt that Aaliyah matured, calling her progress a declaration of strength and independence. ABC News noted that Aaliyah's music was evolving from the punchy pop-influenced hip-hop and R&B to a more mature, introspective sound on her third album. Stephen Thomas Early Wine of AllMusic described her eponymous album, Aaliyah, as a statement of maturity and a stunning artistic leap forward, and called it one of the strongest urban soul records of its time. She portrayed unfamiliar sounds, styles and emotions, but managed to please critics with the contemporary sound it contained. Ernest Hardy of Rolling Stone felt that Aaliyah reflected a stronger technique, where she gave her best vocal performance. Prior to her death, Aaliyah expressed a desire to learn about the burgeoning UK garage scene she had heard about at the time. Influences. As an artist, Aaliyah often voiced that she was inspired by a number of performers. These include Michael Jackson, Stevie Wonder, Sade, En Vogue, Nine Inch Nails, Korn, Prince, Naughty by Nature, Johnny Mathis, Janet Jackson, and Barbara Streisand. Aaliyah expressed that Michael Jackson's Thriller was her favorite album and that nothing will ever top Thriller. She stated that she admired Sade because she stays true to her style no matter what. She's an amazing artist, an amazing performer, and I absolutely love her. Aaliyah expressed she had always desired to work with Janet Jackson, whom she had drawn frequent comparison to over the course of her career, stating, "I admire her a great deal. She's a total performer. I'd love to do a duet with Janet Jackson." Jackson reciprocated Aaliyah's affections, commenting, "I've loved her from the beginning because she always comes out and does something different, musically." Jackson also stated she would have enjoyed collaborating with Aaliyah. Image. Aaliyah focused on her public image throughout her career. She often wore baggy clothes and sunglasses, stating that she wanted to be herself. She described her image as being important, to differentiate yourself from the rest of the pack. She often wore black clothing, starting a trend for similar fashion among women in United States and Japan. Aaliyah's fashionable style has been credited for being an influence on new fashion trends called health goth and ghetto goth, also known as GHE20 goth. 1K Aaliyah participated in fashion designer Tommy Hilfiger's All-America Tour and was featured in Tommy Jean ads, which depicted her in boxer shorts, baggy jeans and a tube top. Hilfiger's brother, Andy, called it a whole new look that was classy but sexy. Carson Daly, a former VJ on MTV's Total Request Live, commented on Aaliyah's style by saying that she was cutting edge, always one step ahead of the curve, and that the TRL audience looks to her to figure out what's hot and what's new. When she changed her hairstyle, Aaliyah took her mother's advice to cover her left eye, Much like Veronica Lake, the look has become known as her signature and been referred to as fusion of unnerving emotional honesty and a sense of mystique. In 1998, she hired a personal trainer to keep in shape, and exercised 5 days a week and ate diet foods. Aaliyah was praised for her clean-cut image and moral values. Robert Christgau of The Village Voice wrote of Aaliyah's artistry and image, "She was lithe and dulcet in a way that signified neither jailbait nor haughty, an ingenue whose selling point was sincerity, not innocence and the obverse it implies." Aaliyah was viewed by others as a role model. Emil Welbeckin, described by CNN as a friend of Aaliyah's and follower of her career, explained, "Aaliyah is an excellent role model, because she started her career in the public eye at age 15 with a gold album entitled Age Ain't Nothing But a Number. And then her second album, One in a Million, went double platinum. She had the leading role in Romeo Must Die, which was a box office success. She's won numerous awards, several MTV Music Video Awards, and aside from her professional successes, many of her lyrics are very inspirational and uplifting. She also carried herself in a very professional manner. She was well-spoken. She was beautiful, but she didn't use her beauty to sell her music. She used her talent. Many young hip-hop fans greatly admire her. She also was seen by others as a sex symbol. Aaliyah did not have a problem with being considered one. I know that people think I'm sexy and I'm looked at as that, and it is cool with me," she stated. "It's wonderful to have sex appeal. If you embrace it, it can be a very beautiful thing. I am totally cool with that. Definitely. I see myself as sexy. If you are comfortable with it, it can be very classy and it can be very appealing." The single We Need a Resolution was argued to have transformed the once tomboy into a sexy grown woman. Aaliyah mentioned that her mother, during her childhood, would take pictures of her and notice a sex appeal. She reinforced her mother's belief by saying that she did feel sexy for sure and that she embraced it and was comfortable with this view of her.